afternoon, my dear students. Today I will take you in the world of live beautiful botany class. Now I would like to show you some of the things. What could you tell me? What are these?
Flowers.
Okay, nice. Today our topic is flowering plants of angiosperms. So now, angiosperms. These angiosperms always flowers and they will give fruits and seeds. There are 250,000 angiosperm species are there in all over the world. Out of 250,000, we in our India, it's a very good biodiversity of we are having 18,500 species. So these 18,500 species or 250,000 species, we can group into two equal groups by using one very important unique character. That character is based on the seeds, because all angiosperms will give seeds. Now I would like to show you some of the seeds. You look at these seeds. These are the seeds of batani and also cashew nut, and also this is chana and groundnut. In all these seeds we can see one important character where we can equally get two equal halves when it is splitted into the suture. It means we are getting two equal halves. It means there are two cotyledons in the embryo of each seed. It means if any seed contains two cotyledons, that we can group as a dicots. Dicots. So the second grouping, if you look after same, like this is the rice and this is the maize, we cannot split these seeds into two equal halves. It means it is having only a single cotyledon. It means this is called monocots. So this is about monocots. Then now we already differentiated, you see, 250,000 of world species. We are differentiated with only one unique character, dicots and monocots. If you want further more key characters of dicots and monocots, we can also differentiate with the help of some other characters. So first key character I will take, you see, look after this, the root, there is a only single root, it is called a tap root system, and this is the character of dicot. If you don't have any like seeds, just with the help of root also you can differentiate. And at the same time, you see here, there is no any tap root, only one fibrous roots is there, or adventitious roots are there. So in the roots, if adventitious roots are there, simply you say monocot. If it is tap root is there, you say simply dicot. Then we will go for another key characters, that is called with the help of leaf. You may not get root, you may not get seed, but compulsory you will get the leaves of every plants, all the places. Then just pluck the one leaf and check how the venation it is. So just the veins are nicely arranged in the reticulate manner. It means net-like manner. This is called reticulate venation. If the leaf contains reticulate venation, by closing eyes you should say that is a dicot plant. Then you see, look after this one. There is no any reticulate venation here, only parallel venation. It means all the veins are arranged as a parallelly. You might be observed in the wheat leaves also, maize leaves also, rice leaves also, this character, even grass leaves also. It means all those are monocots. So these are the some important characters. If other important characters like flowers, if the four or five mirrors, it means four parts each, that is dicot character, three parts is a monocot character. If somebody, they will get only a small stem, they don't have any morphology, then we can go for anatomical characters. If in the anatomy, if you cut any stem of any small stem, that will be considered as a rounded, it means ringed vascular bundles, that is dicot. If it is normal vascular bundles, it is called scattered vascular bundles, it is called monocot. So with this, I am concluding that now you are able to identify all the monocots and dicots. So I am summarizing my work. You see here, two cotyledons, one cotyledon, tap root system, adventitious root system, reticulate venation, parallel venation, flowers four or five mirrors, flowers trimerous, ringed vascular bundles, scattered vascular bundles, secondary growth present, secondary growth absent. This is what today our class. Now I would like to show only a small leaf. You should say immediately, Which leaf it is? Dicot or monocot?
Dicot.
Dicot, nice. Which leaf it is? Monocot. Thank you. Now I would like to give one assignment. Tomorrow you go and check you whatever the plants available and identify monocot and dicot. Finally, without showing element, I am giving one. Which banana? Monocot or dicot? Banana leaf.
Monocot.
Monocot. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.